So this is my 2001 Jeep Grand Cherokee Laredo, and it doesn't start. You see, the key light up here comes on, and none of my gauges come up. And if I start it, none of my gauges come up, and the key light stays on and it stalls. The engine light also comes on, and I think the code, and we get a code that if I look up says issues communicating with the SKIM module. Now the SKIM module is right there beneath the column. And if I unplug this cable from the SKIM module, let me come up here and I'll start it over again. And you'll see the SKIM light does not come on right away. I'll give it some time. See if it shows up. So far, not showing up. But if we try to, oh, there we go. Now it's on. And if we try to start it, same thing will happen. Okay. Something else to notice. My overhead information center works. And my door locks work. My windows work. My door locks work. So, now, why is it important that the overhead console and the doors work? Well, the dashboard, the SKIM module, the door modules, and again, you can see up here, we're getting data. They all work on the same PCI one-wire bus that the SKIM module works on. So if my bus was shorted, I would expect to be having issues with other devices on the PCI bus. Now, the dashboard here is also on the PCI bus, but you'll see that some of the things on the dashboard are working. So that leads me to believe that it's not the bus itself. So one of the problems that can cause this is your bus is shorted. I actually spent like 2.5 days going through checking wires. And one of the spots that you can have problems with wires being shorted out is down here. Now, this was someone else had cut into here and already fixed, quote unquote, fixed it. And that fix broke. And so I did have the thick black wire in here broken, which is causing the door module not to work. So repairing that wire got my doors working, but it did not fix the rest of the issue. One of the other problems is you can have is on the passenger side, same thing. I think all the doors actually probably have it, even the hatch. And then let's see, go outside. Some of the other place things that can cause the problem. Let me get out here. I actually bought this truck this way. Friend of mine said, you want it for $100, otherwise it's going to the junkyard, because he didn't want to deal with it. There is a connector down here, way down here, that goes to a crank sensor. And there is also a sensor right here that goes to, I think they call that a throttle body position sensor or something. Anyway, there's three sensors that can also cause these problems because they use the same 5-volt rail that PCI bus and the computer uses. And so if they're shorted to ground or shorted or having issues, they can cause the PCI bus and the computer not to work. So I unplugged that one, and that didn't make a difference. So I took that one out and I tested it.
I tested for 5 volts on that line to make sure the 5 volt circuit was actually working, and I got 5 volts, no problems. So that didn't give me any grief. Another thing that was offered as a suggested test point was to come up here. This is the plug here for the SKIM module. And the pink wire and the blue wire are 5 volt. And this black and orange wire is ground. So you can put just an automotive light bulb on some wires and do a load test to see if we're actually keeping power to the SKIM module. And so putting a 12 volt light bulb across these two lines lit the light bulb just fine. And putting a 12 volt light bulb across these two lines lit it just fine. This wire, this yellow wire, that's your PCI bus. That's how the SKIM module communicates with the rest of the vehicle. All right, now, other diagnostics you can possibly do. So if you take this off and you look down there, I don't know if you can see it or not, we're looking for this connector. I don't know if you can see it, but there is a connector right there. There's a plastic connector, and it has a cap on it. So that light bulb's hot, but anyway, there's a cap on it, and if you pull that cap, so I can get that cap pulled. You take this off. There's just a screw here, and a screw here. And then, sorry about the video. I'm trying to be useful, not pretty. And there's a bolt right there. And a bolt right there. And this comes off, and then you can get at that cap under there. And what you'll find is if you disconnect that cap, what that cap does is it connects all the one wire devices together in the car. So your overhead console should stop working. Your doors, I think, stop working. And again, here you can see my door sensors are functioning and the overhead console are working, and that's all communicating over the one wire bus. Why am I zooming in? Because I zoomed in to show you that wire. Let's back off. That's kind of sucked. I did put an oscilloscope on this wire, and I could see it going from 0 to 8 volts or whatever in the data blips. So, you know, I could see the data's flying along. So that tells me that probably something wrong with the computer. Engine temperature, oil, fuel, battery, all that is probably coming from the PCM, the powertrain computer module. Oh, as I shut the door, the last thing you should probably, one of the other things you should be aware of is there's a fuse box here. Okay. And there's fuses up here. And there's actually some relays way up high too. And then the body computer is right on the back of this. And so you can actually reach up here and unplug the body, the BCM, body control module. And so you can unplug that too if you wanted to do some testing. This is the data port. You can also, there's some other people who have some good videos on doing some testing using that port, but not really gonna go into that. So found several good articles that go over this, and one of them was a fellow who had the exact same problem I'm having, and what he did is he pulled his computer and he sent it into, I got my new computer here yet, I haven't put it in, from all computer resources to have the SKIM module deleted. So with the SKIM module deleted, he put the computer back in, car fired right up, but he still had no gauges. And I found some other
items online where people have the same issue and they bought a new replacement computer from All Computer Resources, put it in, and that fixed their problem. So what this really looks like to me is that the PCI bus on the computer is having issues. Now, if I sat here long enough with the SKIM module plugged in, my key light would disappear for a minute, or like 20 seconds, and my gauges would come up. I think the gauges would come up anyway, but then it would disappear again. And I towed this vehicle into the dealer and had them hook their computer up, and they saw the SKIM module, and so they were like, okay, well, let's reprogram it. And then they attempted to reprogram it, and they lost communication with the SKIM module, and after that, they couldn't detect any modules. So that goes back to me thinking that the PCI bus on the computer itself is bad. So I guess I got myself a new computer here. Unfortunately, I didn't get a chance to put it in last night, and I won't for tonight or tomorrow or the next day because I have other obligations after work. Oh, there's my doggies. What's up, gypsy dog? Woof, woof, woof. Hey, bow dog. All right, go. Go play. All right, now try not to be too shaky. So, next step for me on this 2001 Jeep Cherokee Laredo is to pull the windshield wiper or engine coolant overflow. And that's where my computer is, right there. One other thing you can do to test, I think it's pin 30 or 33 on this connector right here, the gray connector. You'd have to look it up online. But you can test continuity between the SKIM module's data port and the computer to make sure that that's got continuity. And that all had continuity, so I don't have a wiring problem between there and here. Suppose I could have load tested that connection, but that's probably the only test I didn't do before I ordered the computer. So if it doesn't work after this, maybe I'll do that. So sometime I'll finish this video by installing the computer and showing y'all if it works or not.